What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Legit Looks for Life. Today I'm with my boy Noah, and today I have a special new type of video content for you guys. So I know that a lot of you guys have been wanting me to go hit up thrifts, and a lot of you guys have been saying, Tim, yo, go back to thrift stores, do thrift store, do trip to the thrift and stuff. So I am gonna go back to the thrift. However, I am not just coming back like I used to be. I want to do, it is a new year, I have a lot of fresh new ideas, and I have new concepts that I want to do. So if you guys know about me, most of you do not know the side of me that I am a true businessman and entrepreneur, which means basically, yes, I am a YouTuber, but the same passion that I have for YouTube, if not more, I have for business. So I've always been an entrepreneur, and I realize on this channel, guys, that you guys love steals, and not only do I want to help you guys find steals, but I also, for those of you who aren't really big sneakerheads, or maybe you're up and coming, or maybe you're not even into sneakers, I want to start telling you guys how much the things that I find are worth and how much we can flip them for and how much of a profit we can make. I know a lot of these shows are big on television. They do like flea market flippers. They have like people that flip houses. On this channel, I want to do the same thing that I've been doing, which is steals and deals, which is like Ross, Marshalls, pawn shop, thrift store. But however, I want to tell you guys how much the item costs, how much we can potentially flip it for if it's a good flip. And hopefully you guys like this concept. So we're gonna start off going to the thrift store and seeing what we can find today. Okay, guys, so we're here at the first Goodwill location. Hopefully we're gonna be coming up upon some heat that we can make a profit off of. We can find some steals in here. So let's go ahead inside and look. Check out all these video games in here, guys. I've never really messed with video games, like for resale, but I wonder if these would be good. So many of them. So I got some Under Armour sneakers. I'm not too familiar with Under Armour sneakers. In order to make a profit off of these, you would have to have knowledge behind the brand. And I mean, I guess we could look up for how much they're worth, but they're pretty used. They got a couple scuffs, so something like this probably wouldn't go for too much, to be honest. Now this, on the other hand, the LeBron.
They have two pairs.
LeBron 12s.
$10 each.
For $10 each. Now this could be a pretty big profit gain. The bottom's kind of dirty. But you can always clean them up and stuff like that. But the sizing is what really affects it, though. This is a size. This is actually size 8.5, which is a man's size. So it's pretty good, honestly. If it was a kid size, then things would be different. But I think we're gonna go ahead and pick these up. And then what else do they have in here? Is this another pair? Yeah, this is another pair of them. These are almost fairly newer. And wow, pretty good finds. These are a size 5.5, guys. So they have two pairs, $10 each. These are a size 5.5. These are a size 8.5. And then they have some of these Hyper Dunks. Now these I don't really mess with too much just because they're basketball performance shoes, but LeBron's tend to do really well. And then what else do they have in here? Wow, they have some pretty good sneakers in here, guys. I usually don't come to this location. This is actually the first time, but I think for sure something that we can count on for sure is these two pairs of LeBron. So I think we're gonna go ahead and scoop both of those up. And other than that, guys, pretty much just have like cleats and stuff like that. So gonna go ahead and scoop those up first. I didn't even see these Air Maxes either, guys, but we got these. These probably won't do too well just because they're not like as hyped. So for these, they're $6.99. Probably could make a little bit of profit, but they'll probably be selling for a long time. Another pair we just came across are these Kobe 9 All-Star Games. These are the high top version. And these are in a smaller size. These are in a size 4Y. Now, I usually tend to stay away from sneakers in a smaller size just because they're harder to sell. But we're gonna go ahead and look up how much these go for and see if we can make anything off of these. Got this Ralph Lauren polo tee right here in a size extra large for $2.99. That is an incredible price for this, guys, because if you guys know, these go for a lot. So this is gonna be a good cop as well, man. $2.99 is amazing. Found this on the bias tee right here. This is from Paxson, $2.99 in a size medium, but you can't really do much with this one, guys. Honestly, you can probably make a little bit of profit, but not too much. So something like this might trick the average shopper. This is US Polo Assassin. Don't get it mixed up for Ralph Lauren polo, because this one does not go for anything nearly as much as Ralph Lauren does. If you would have shown me this when I was a freshman in high school, I wouldn't believe you, and I would have went crazy, just because if you wore a diamond when we were in high school, it meant that you had money, in my opinion. And like, I guess I couldn't really afford all the diamond tees, but this one is $2.99 and it is in a size large, but it probably won't do too well just because, I mean, diamond isn't like as big as it used to be. This was a pretty dope brand too back in high school. Crooks and Castles, $2.99. I know a lot of you guys might like it too. It's a size large. This used to be one of those brands too that was really popping back in the day for me, but as of right now, you know, it's not as big as it used to be. Found this Superman jersey too. I know this isn't like super hype or anything. $4.29. I thought it was pretty cool find. But yeah, guys, other than that, that's pretty much it. So I'm gonna go ahead and cash out what we did find right now. Alright guys, just coming out of that Goodwill, got three pairs of shoes. Didn't pick up the polo shirt after all because I remember that they didn't do too well. And I already have like polo stuff on the site and it didn't do too well. However, I haven't tried eBay yet, so we might have to experiment with that. But yeah guys, got the three pairs of shoes. We can go more into depth of how much they're worth and how much they'll sell for when we get back to the home. And yeah, so I paid about $28, so roughly around $10 per each shoe. But yeah, we'll do all the calculations and stuff and see how much profit I'm gonna get off of these when we get back home. All right guys, next stop is Uptown Cheapskate. Now usually they charge more here, but the actual like items and sneakers and stuff are actually in better condition, so we're gonna see if we can find any good deals here. All right guys, so first off, our finds are the pennies right here, these pennies right here. And these aren't really worth too much. They're size 8.5. So we're gonna have to, how much are they asking for them though? That's the thing. $22.99. See, it's a little bit more than a thrift, guys. They got these. We got the Reebok questions in here, guys. And these kind of look like a Valentine's Day colorway, man, if I do say so myself. These resale isn't too good on them, but I mean, it's still a dope sneaker, man. $23.99. If you're gonna cop for yourself, it wouldn't be too bad. What, vape?
That was vape.
Yeah, we got these Son of Mars in here. These, I would peep these in high school. Like, I really wanted these back in high school. These are, dude, these are like, they started at 35, but nobody's bought them in a long time, so they're reduced to 17.47. Huh, 8.5. I'm gonna think about these guys, because you might be able to, make a little bit of profit on this one. Kyrie ones, oh, dope.
They're beat though.
They are kind of beat, yeah.
It's not worth $35.
Yeah, it's not worth $35 to make a profit. Maybe if you're gonna get them for yourself, yeah, it'd be dope, but
even then,
dude, check out these Puma 3Ms. These are actually sick, size 10.5. How much are they asking for these ones? $22.99. These all blue Puma suedes. These are sick for $18. So is it Yeezy season or what? Did we just find Yeezys in the thrift time? Did we just find Yeezys in the thrift? That boost is perfect. Like, you cannot, oh my gosh, it's like rock hard. Feel it? Feel that boost?
Dang.
It's like super hard, right? Anyways, guys, these are fake Yeezys. Can't make anything off of these, man. You really can't. At the end of the day, don't do it, guys. Just don't do it. They're $14. Just don't do it. Don't resell fakes. You'll get in big trouble. Y'all, they have these Air Jordan 1s in here. These look honestly brand new. Like, I have a feeling somebody just bought them from the mall and brought them over here. They're asking, hold up, they're asking $60 for these. Okay, on these, this might be a good come up, guys. I'm not sure if we can make a profit on these. I'm gonna do a little bit of research and see if we can get anything from this one. So on StockX, guys, these are 150 dead stock. So if I do purchase them, I'll probably sell them for like $100. Also, guys, wanted to show this dead stock Cowboys hat right here. This one is Team NFL and it is vintage. They're asking $6.99. I haven't had any luck with these hats in the past, so I'm gonna go ahead and pass on these, but if you guys do want stuff like this, let me know and I'll start copying it. Alright guys, so just picked up a pair of those Air Jordans, man. These things are clean, guys. These things are really clean. So I have a special announcement to make about Uptown Cheapskate. I'm really gonna hook you guys up this time. I'm really, really gonna hook you guys up. So stay tuned till the end, and I'll let you guys know how you can get 20% off your Uptown Cheapskate purchase because they noticed you guys. Shout out to all you guys who have been shouting me out at this Uptown Cheapskate. They wanna work with me on something, which means it's gonna benefit you guys. So stay tuned till the end of the video. We're gonna continue this right now and talk about how much profit we're gonna make, talk about what we found, and you know, talk about everything. So let's continue this video when we get home. All right guys, we're now back home. Let's go ahead and get into these pickups that I picked up today. So basically guys, the thing that I wanna change about this series, guys, is I don't want it to only be, oh, I found this, I found that, I found this. I want to tell you guys how much I got it for, how much I can sell it for, how much market value is, and how much profit I made off of it. Because let's be honest guys, you guys know I sell on the website and everybody's always asking, well, how can I make money for sneakers? How can I make extra money? And I think it's a really good way to show you guys how to make extra money by flipping thrift store stuff. So it's really, I hope that this series is really interesting to you guys because I know a lot of people like, you know, those shows on TV where you see them flip stuff. So I thought, hey, why not do it like that show but make it integrated to where I can do sneakers and, you know, some clothing some of the times. So I hope you guys don't see it as a negative way. I hope you guys don't think like I'm a big reseller or whatever, because it's not really being a reseller because I'm not
getting the shoes new from the store and camping and taking a whole bunch of shoes that people want. I'm actually using stuff that people don't want anymore, which is, some people might see it as trash, which is, you know, they might just throw it in a thrift store, not want it anymore. But for me, I see it as trash that you can make a flip off of and make it into treasure. So that is what we're gonna start doing. I hope you guys enjoy this series. And if you guys do, you know, we'll use it towards Nike Outlet, Marshalls, pawn shops, flea markets, everything that I've done in the past, we'll bring it back for this series. So let's go ahead and get started with the first pair of sneakers. Now this one I got at the first Goodwill we went to, and these are the LeBron 12s Independence Days. Now I got this for a steal of a price. These things only ran me $10, and they are a size 8.5. So because of the condition that they are in, you know, they're in okay condition. They're not super beat. They have been worn, however, the bottoms are pretty dirty, but they're not like extremely beat to the point where somebody could not wear them anymore. Now the person who did have them did get some use out of them, but for $10, you really cannot go wrong. And I've been researching and I've been looking at how much they go for. And you know, on eBay, I'm looking at the used listings. And for most of them, they're going for like 130, 125. So I think that if I were to sell these, I would probably price them at, I wanna say around somewhere in between $50 to $75, just because they are in that used condition. They wouldn't be selling for something that is in VNDS or something that is brand new, but I think that somewhere between the $50 and $75 range will still be a great price for these. So I bought these for $10, so if I sell them for $75, that's a $65 profit from these shoes. Next up, I got these little ones, and these are a size 5.5. These are the LeBron 12 Independence Day, and honestly, these are in a way better condition than the other ones. Now these are, they do have a few scuffs on them and stuff like that, like on this side especially, they do have a few scuffs, but I ended up purchasing these for $10 as well, and I know this isn't gonna be as much profit as the other one, but since these are $10, I'm gonna go ahead and flip them for, I wanna say somewhere between $30 and $50, so if I do sell them for $50, and that is a $40 profit, because these are a size 5.5, they do not go as much as the men's sizes do, so I would have to flip it in between $30 and $50, so let's just say I made a $40 profit from this sneaker. So far the profits from today are $105 in total, just from those two LeBrons. Let's see what else I picked up. Okay, so I also picked up a pair of these Kobe 4 All-Stars from the same Goodwill. This Goodwill was loaded, it had a lot of sneakers in it, and I picked these ones up for only $5.99. Now I believe that the reason why they were priced so low is because they are a youth size, but these things aren't even that bad of a condition, to be completely honest with you guys. And most of the time what happens with kids is either they'll outgrow it, or, you know, I don't know, something like that, but these aren't even in that used of a condition, so this is a pretty good find in my opinion. Now I have been looking, and these shoes honestly do go for a lot of money. Like, I was looking online, I've seen this size go for like anywhere from $90 to $140. So for this shoe, since it is in a pretty good condition, not too worn, but it is still used, I will probably charge somewhere between $50 and $75 for this one. So let's say I do charge $75, it is about a $70 profit from this shoe alone. It all depends, guys, on the colorway that you get. It all depends on the type of shoe that you get, and it all depends on how limited they are, or, you know, how much people want them, and of course the sizing, because if this was an adult size, I would have made a lot more profit off of it than I would this size. And last but not least, my pickups from Uptown Cheapskate. We have a pair of the Air Jordan 1s. These are in a type of Olympic colorway, and guys, when I found these, I was blown away because of the condition that they are in. They're in extremely good condition. And this is just beautiful, guys, like no creases whatsoever, except for like a little tiny baby one on the toe box. So in my opinion, you know, these are very near dead stock, however, they are not dead stock. I picked these up for $60, and I was looking at the prices on these online, and these are going for like $120, but that is brand new, so I'll probably end up selling these for about $80. So since I bought them for $60 and I'm selling them for $80, I'm only gonna make like a $20 profit off of these, but you know, since they are, you know, the Air Jordan 1s, and since they are the Olympic, these are gonna sell faster than the other ones, just because this is a really nice pair of shoes. And you know, it's all about timing too, because those other ones I might not sell as fast, but these are definitely gonna sell fast, especially for that $80 price point. So that's a $20 profit from this pair of shoes right now. All right, guys, so an overview of everything that we picked up today. We got these LeBron 12 Independence Days in a size 8.5, which we bought for $10, and the highest price that we will sell these for are $75, so the highest profit that we'll make is $65 profit. These are a smaller size, these are a size 5.5, and since they are a smaller size, they won't go for as much. So we picked these up for $10 as well, and we'll probably sell them for somewhere around $50 maximum, so that's a $40 profit from these. Picked up these Kobe 9 All-Stars, which are a pretty good find, however, they are in a size
4, so that means that I will not make as much as I would if they were a man size, but only pick these up for only $5.99, which is an incredible price, guys. And so the maximum that I can flip these for most likely will probably be somewhere around $75, so that will be a $70 profit. And then I picked up these Air Jordan 1 in this Olympic metallic gold type of colorway. So I picked these up for $60. I'm gonna sell them for around $80. So I will probably make about $20 from these.
So in total, the profits that I will make from the sneakers today will be around $195. I would say that's pretty good for a day's work. Now remember, if you guys wanna do this, it is a great way to make money as a kid. You need money to make money. So make sure that you have money in order to spend. You don't have to buy everything the first time you see it. You can build up yourself. And if you guys wanna see more entrepreneur videos such as this, to where I teach you guys how to sell on eBay, so where I teach you guys how to ship stuff, all that good stuff. You know, like I said, guys, an entrepreneur is what I am, and the business is in my blood. So let me know if you guys enjoyed this series. If you guys do want to see me make flips off of other stuff, let me know in the comments down below. As always, guys, if you guys did enjoy this series and you guys want to see many more videos on this, leave a big thumbs up. Also, if you're interested in any of those shoes, I will be posting them on eBay, but I will probably also be selling them on my website. So if you guys are interested in those, click on the link down in the description. And if you guys want to cop the shoes, message me on Instagram. I'm gonna hook you up with a dope deal on them. So thank you guys for watching. I hope you guys enjoyed this little trip to the thrift. Oh, and one more thing, guys. If you guys are interested in going to Uptown Cheapskate, I was talking to the owner there in San Antonio, Texas. If you guys want to walk in Uptown Cheapskate, tell them that you saw my video. Say, I'm here because Legit Looks for Life sent me, the YouTuber thrifter. You know, they'll pretty much figure it out when you say Legit Looks for Life. But you guys will receive an exclusive 20% off just for my subscribers, just by going in there, guys. So keep on shopping at Uptown Cheapskate. Keep on looking for those dope steals. And thank you guys for everybody who was mentioning me to the owners, because they have taken interest in our YouTube channel and they are enjoying it. So hopefully we can work out some dope things for you guys in the future. But yeah, guys, check out Uptown Cheapskate. Tell them Legit Looks for Life sent you, so you guys can get an exclusive 20% off your purchase. Thank you guys for watching this video, and I'll see y'all in the next video. Peace, homies. Stay blessed. We're out of here.